Hello, class 7th. In our today's session, we are going to look for a poem. Okay? And what is the name of that poem? The name of that poem is The Shed. The name of that poem is The Shed. Okay? Who is the poet of this poem? The poet of this poem is Frank Flynn. Frank Flynn. This is a poet of this poem. What are we going to see in this poem? In this poem, first we will have an introduction about the poet of this poem. Then we will read the poem and then the explanation of the poem stanza wise. Okay? Then we'll move for the vocabulary also. Because it is a poem and there may be many words in this poem which may be new for you. Fine? So, first let's have an introduction about the poet. Now, about the poet. Frank Flynn, he was born on 6th December 1906. He was born on 6th December 1906. He got educated in Sydney, receiving MBBS with first class. About his education, if we talk, he had received MBBS with first class honors in 1930. Then later in 1931, he sailed to England. And in 1931 and 1933-34, he studied and worked at the Royal Ophthalmic Hospital. That is in Moorfields. Moorfields in London. Okay. Prior to World War II, he had made several important contributions. Okay. To the study of eye disease, including the introduction of a new drug which he named Midriasis. Okay, means here for the eye disease he introduced a new drug, new medicine. And what was the name of that medicine? He named that medicine as Midriasis. The design and patenting of a machine used in operating on detached retinas. Ophthalmic hospital means eye hospital. Okay, and he was studying about that only. He was a composer, he was a songwriter, author, and drummer in orchestras, including those of Rudy Will, Freddie Martin, and Tommy and Jimmy Dorsey. These are the other poets. He was inspired by them. He returned to Sydney in 1934 and then he joined the missionary of the Sacred Heart in December 1935. He was ordained in a priest in March 1942 and was sent to the Northern Territory. From 1942 to 1945, he worked with army hospitals. And from 1946 to 1968, he was consulting ophthalmologist to the Northern Territory Department of Health. His activity as a consulting ophthalmologist to the Northern Territory Trachoma and Eye Health Program continued till 1992. Okay? And from 1944 to 1946, he studied anthropology with Professor Alkin and gained diploma of anthropology at University of Sydney with the intention of gaining a wider knowledge and appreciation of Aboriginal culture, of genealogy and academic methods of field research. Now, if we talk about more of his writings, okay, which more poem did he write other than this? Then in 1947 he wrote Distant Horizon. In 1963 he wrote a book named Northern Gateway. In 1964 he wrote The Living Heart with Keith Valley. And in 1968 he wrote Northern Frontiers, that also with Keith Valley. So these are some of his, you can say, writings or his literatures which he wrote in the form of poems and books. Okay, so this was our poet Frank Flynn. Let's move to the poem. First we will read the poem, okay, and then we will move to the explanation stanza wise. The Shed. The name of the poem is The Shed. There's a shed at the bottom of our garden. There's a shed at the bottom of our garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. With a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I am in bed, I lie and listen. When I am in bed, I lie and listen. I will open that door one day. I will open that door one day. This is the first stanza. Second, there's a dusty old window around at the side. I read again. There's a dusty old window around at the side with three cracked panes of glass. With three cracked panes of glass. I often think that someone's staring at me each time that I pass. I often think that someone's staring at me each time that I pass. I will peep through that window one day. Third stanza. My brother says there's a ghost in the shed. The poet brother says that there is a ghost in the shed. Who hides under the rotten floorboards. Who hides under the rotten floorboards. And if I ever dare to set foot inside. If I ever dare to set foot inside. He will jump out and chop off my head. He will jump out and chop off my head. But I will take a peep one day. Last stanza. I know that there isn't really a ghost. I know that there isn't really a ghost. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. There isn't anyone staring and making strange noises. There isn't anyone staring and making strange noises. The spider has been gone from his web since I don't know when. The spider has been gone from his web since I don't know when. I will go into that shed one day soon, but not just yet. I will soon go into the shed one day soon, but I will soon go into that shed one day, but not just yet. This is the poem. Okay. While reading the poem, I hope you must have understood what is the poet trying to say and what is the poem about. Now to understand more easily, let's move to the explanation stanza wise. First four lines. There's a shed for the first stanza you can say, there's a shed at the bottom of our garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I am in the bed, I lie and listen. I will open that door one day. Now, what is the poet trying to say in this first stanza? Okay, here the poet is, you can say, describing about his shed. Where is the shed? The shed is at the bottom of his garden. Okay, at the bottom of the garden, there is a shed. Now, here he says, with a spider web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. Means here is trying to say that hardly anybody can go inside the shed because the hinges means the, you can say, what is the spelling of hinges first? Let's see. It is H-I-N-G-E-S, hinges. Okay, what is hinges? Hinges means a joint device or flexible piece on which the door, gate or shutter moves or swings. Okay, this is a door, this is a door. Okay, now if I open this door, then if I open this door, so the device that joins, the jointed device which joins the two doors. Okay, so what does the poet say? The poet says that hardly anybody goes into that shed. And because of it, the hinges of the joints have become rusty. And now because they have become rusty, they make a lot of noise. You must have heard the doors when they are, when the doors are old, they make a creaking sound. Such kind of, okay. Whenever the wind makes them move. And when do these doors make the noise? Whenever there is a breeze or very, when the wind is very high, at that time these doors bang and the hinges of the doors make the sound. Okay, when the poet, and when does the poet hear this? The poet hears this very peacefully when he is laying in the bed. Okay, he sometimes hears that noise from the shed. And what is the wish of the poet? The wish of the poet is that he will open that door one day. Right now, because the shed is in the bottom of the garden and he is a small boy, he doesn't wish to go to that shed. But one day, he will open that door, says the poet. Okay. Then, what does he wish more? What does the poet wish is more? There's a dusty old window around at the side. First, he was talking about the door, that the door is rusty, the door makes creaking sound and all. And now he is talking about the window. There's a dusty old window around at a side with three cracked panes of glass. I often think there's someone staring at me each time that I pass. I will peep through that window one day. Sorry. I will peep through that window one day. Now, what is the poet trying to say? The poet here is discussing that how he wishes to stare inside that window. First, he was willing or wishing that he could get open that door and get into the shed. Now, further, he wishes that how could he stare inside the shed? He says that the shed is very dusty. The shed has dusty old window on its side where there are glass panes, and that glass panes are broken. Okay. Now here the poet is also trembling. I often think there's someone staring at me each time that I pass. Means in this line the poet is trying to say that whenever he passes through that shed, He feels that someone is inside the shed and he is staring at him. He is keeping an eye on the poet. So that's why the poet wishes that he could peep into that window one day and see who is keeping an eye on him. Who is watching him? He wanted to see that. Okay? What is the poet trying to say in this stanza? He is trying to say that the window, that the shed has dusty window on its side and the window panes are broken. Okay? Whenever the poet passes through that shed, he feels that somebody is staring at him. And so the poet wants to peep through that window to see who is watching him, who is staring at him. Okay, now after all this, when the poet knew about the doors and the windows of the shed, his brother only warns him. Why? Because poet is very small, and so his brother warns him. What does his brother warn him? My brother says there's a ghost in the shed. What does the brother say? Poet's brother say that there is a ghost in the shed who hides under the rotten floorboards. And if I ever dare to set foot inside, he will jump out and chop off my head. But I will take a peek one day. Okay? In this line, the poet discusses how his brother is warning him about the ghost inside the shed. And why is his brother doing so? His brother is doing so that the poet will not dare to go inside the shed. The poet's brother talks about the presence of the ghost inside the shed. And he says to the poet that if you step inside the shed, there is a ghost inside, and that ghost is hiding under the rotten floorboard. So if you try to get into the shed, he will jump out and chop off your head. Okay? But then too the poet says that though my brother has warned me, I am not at all frightened of the poet. I am not at all frightened of the poet. After so much of warning also, the poet is willing to get into the shed and see for himself that is there any ghost, as my brother has told me. That's why it has been written, I will take a peek one day. Means here the poet is still wishing that one day he will step inside the shed and see for himself that the warning which has been given by my brother, is it true or no? So understood this stanza, that after knowing about the shed, that it is, the doors are creaking, the window panes are broken, the poet has been warned by his brother that there is a ghost inside the shed that is hiding under the rotten floorboards. Now what is for floorboards? FLOORBOARDS. Floorboards. What is floorboards? Floorboards means a long plank making up part of wooden floor in a building. Okay? What is a floorboard? A floorboard is a long plank making up part of a wooden floor in the building. Okay? So what did poet's brother say? Poet's brother said that there is a ghost inside the shed and he is hiding under the rotten floorboard. Okay, why rotten? Because the shed is old and the floorboards which are there in the shed are now also old. Okay, so that's why the poet's brother is warning him that there is a ghost inside, and if you dare to step inside that shed, the ghost will jump out and chop off your head. But after this warning also, the poet is not at all afraid. He still wishes that he would step inside the shed and have a look on himself, for himself, that is his brother telling the truth. Okay, but the poet here is thinking that he has grown much enough big. Now, after the warning of the brother to the poet, what does the poet think? I know that there isn't really a ghost. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noises. The spider had been gone from his web since I don't know when. I will get into the shed one day soon, but not just yet. Means in these lines, the poet is trying to say that he seems to have grown enough to understand the truth. Here the poet is trying to prove himself, you can say, that he is now grown up. He is not going to listen to anybody's warning. Okay? Here the poet is able to overcome his fears. He is able to understand. Though his brother is warning him, he is able to understand that there isn't any ghost inside the shed. He understands that there is actually nobody inside the shed who stares at him or makes those strange noises. The spider about which the poet was talking is no longer there. This is all a story made by his brother, or you can say this is all being a lies by his brother, because he wanted to retain the shed for his own self. Therefore, the poet is telling that very soon I would be able to set the foot inside the shed. But he also says that it can't happen immediately, because he has to be sure for all the things before stepping into the shed. He has to be sure that his brother's warning is truth or no. He knows that his brother is lying. He knows that there is no one staring from the shed. There is no strange noises in the shed. He had overcome his fears. But then too, it is going to take a bit time. This is not going to happen immediately. Okay? So this was the whole poem which I have explained you stanza wise. Let me give you a short summary in which I will explain you the whole poem in one go, so it would be more easy for you to understand. Now the poem which we read is about the shed, which is written by Frank Flynn. Frank Flynn was born on 6th December 906. He studied in Sydney. He also worked at Royal Ophthalmic Hospital in London. Okay. Other than that, he also studies anthropology with Professor Elkin. And we had seen some of his books by the name Distant Horizon, Northern Gateway, The Living Heart, and Northern Frontiers, and goes on. This is the poet. This was our poet Frank Flynn, who had written the poem The Shed. Okay, the poem is about the shed, which is a very small room away from the main house of the poet. It is located at the bottom of the poet's garden. We had seen in the first stanza, the poet has said, where is his shed? The shed is at the bottom of his garden. And the condition which the poet discussed was very worse. Worse condition means, what did the poet say about? The poet said that there is a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges of the door are rusty and they make a creaking sound, which the poet hears when he lies on the bed silently. Okay, then further the poet said that the window panes are broken. There are windows at the sides of the shed. He often feels that somebody is staring at him from the window whenever he passes from it. Okay, and so he wishes that one day he will peep inside that window and he will open that door. Does that door really make some creaking sound? Further, he also said that his brother threatens him that there is a ghost inside the shed, and that ghost hides himself under the rotten floorboards. If the poet gets into the shed, the ghost will jump out and attack on the poet. Okay, but the poet is not at all scared of this, not at all. He had no fear about that thing which his brother had told him, because he knew that there is no ghost inside the shed. His brother is lying because his brother wanted to keep the shed for his den. And that's why the poet decided that one day he will overcome his fear and get into the shed, but not very immediately. The poet said, I would get into that shed one day, but not very immediately. Okay, so this is about the poem. Now, what is the conclusion? What is the central idea of this poem? What is this poem trying to say? The central idea of the poem is, first is, what is central idea? Before knowing the central idea of the poem, you should know what is the central idea. What does the word central idea means? Central idea means, in the message, if there is a central idea of a passage or a central idea of a poem, means it is the message that the author is trying to get across to the reader. The central idea is not a topic, okay? The central idea is stated as a sentence, okay? And it commonly refers to the informational text, okay? So this is the central idea. Central idea means, you can say, a big point. Fine. So we will see the central idea of this poem. The central idea of the poem Shed is rationality and fearlessness. Means you should not fear for anything unless and until you are confirmed about it. Don't go through anybody's saying. If anybody tells you that there is a ghost there, never trust on such things. Okay? The poem teaches us that we should not believe in baseless and imaginative things. Okay? Don't believe on the imaginations that the ghosts live on the neem tree. Many times you must have heard from many of them, right? But that's not true. Never believe on the imaginative stories about ghosts or any other supernatural creatures, as these stories are mostly used by the people for their own benefit. Why do people do it? People do it because it is their own imagination. Some people do such things only because of their own benefit. So here this poem tries to teach us that we should not believe on baseless and imaginative stories about ghosts or any supernatural creatures. Okay? In the last, we will see with the word meanings. Now over to the vocabulary, or you can say the word meanings glossary. Okay, for the first word, it is hinges, hinges. Hinges. What is hinges? A movable joint of mechanism on which a door, gate or lid of the water tanks swings as it opens or closes. Okay, the movable joint which is there between the door, lid, gate, when you open or close it. Okay, next, creak, creak. Creak means make a harsh or high pitched sound when being moved. When the doors or windows, they get old, they start making a creaking sound when you open it, when you close it. Okay, it makes a creaking sound. That creaking sound is, or you can say that high pitched sound is known as creak. Floorboards. What is a floorboard? A long plank, wooden plank, you can say. Okay, which is making up a part of a wooden floor. Here in the school or in the your house, you may be having tiled floors, right? But when the floors are wooden floor, then it is called the floorboards. A long plank making a part of a wooden floor in a building. Peek means to look quickly and go. Peek into the window. Okay, look quickly. Cracked. What is cracked? Damaged and showing lines on the surface from having split without coming apart. Means only a crack, not broken, but only a crack. Okay, damaged or lines. The lines of the cracks are shown in the windows. Okay, they are not broke. You can't say broken. Broken means it breaks into two pieces or many more. Okay, but crack is only a line, surface, from having split without coming apart. Okay, these were the word meanings of the poem Shed, in which we have understood that we should not believe in baseless and imaginative stories about the ghost and other natural other supernatural creatures. Okay, with this our poem is over. We will soon meet in the next session with some more news lessons. Till then, take care of your health. Bye.